Well, I would love to offer you whatever's behind curtain number two.
Into the abyss!
No!
It's okay.
I told
He's
you, Chris!
He'll be back in a second.
Okay.
My question for you is, do you listen to podcasts?
No.
Oh, well, it's your first time. We're so excited for you because we're going to hear a great podcast today. You get to decide which two guests out of three possible guests you want to listen to, and they may have a clue to what's behind curtain number two.
Okay.
So look at Chris's cue card right there. You can listen to the podcast from Commander Brubaker, Chef Tay Lorange, or Tiffany Coyne's Pen Pal. You're going to get to listen to two of them.
Okay.
Who do you want to hear first?
Chef Tay Lorange.
Chef Tay Lorange. All right. Hello and welcome to the podcast. Everyone in your family was wrong about you. Today, we have a really special guest joining us, Chef Tay Lorange.
Oh. It is a pleasure to be here, but I have to correct you. There's no Tay Lorange. It's Tay Orange.
So the L is silent?
Mm-hmm. The L is silent. The apostrophe is silent. The O is strong and the O is the rest of it.
Okay. Well, we're so glad to have you today. People thought
my pleasure.
People thought you would be nothing, and you turned out to be something great.
Absolutely. I climbed the highest heights of culinary passions.
Woo! That's great. Do you, however, have a clue for Margaret or about what's behind curtain number two?
Ooh, curtain number two. As I learned in French school, no.
Oh, which translated means no clue at all.
Mm-hmm.
Now your family was right about you. Get out of here, chef. All right. No clues from Chef Lorange, but we do have Commander Brubaker or Tiffany Coyne's Pen Pal. Who
Tiffany
do you want to hear?
Coyne's Pen Pal.
Okay, let's go listen to that one. Welcome back to the podcast. Tiffany Coyne's Pen Pal. Thank you for finally coming to our podcast. What's your name?
My name is Rick. Ricky.
Ricky.
My name's Ricky.
Should that ankle bracelet be beeping that fast?
It's because, because my parole officer brought me. She said I could have a free date. So, it's lights. Man, so bright up in here, man.
It is.
Hey, where's Tiffany?
Right there. Look, there she is.
Hey, Tiffany. I've been riding you for like 15 seasons. You ain't ripped back yet, but it's okay. Like I said, my 14th letter yesterday.
I got them all.
You got them all?
Yeah.
Did you get the telegram?
I have enough. You can stop sending.
Did you get the Etch-a-Sketch that I made myself using buttons and prison sand?
It was beautiful.
Hey, let's pause in the prison sand for a minute and see if you have a clue for Margaret to what's behind curtain number two.
Yeah, man, I got a clue about curtain number two. It's only something that I've been dreaming of seeing, man.
Okay.
Me and Tiffany go get to see it together, man.
Well, that's probably not going to happen. He got away! Beep. Oh, his beeper. They'll catch him. Oh, you're back!
Yes.
You found the ladder.
Yes, no thanks to you.
Hey, I left the ladder for you.
So, Margaret.
Yes.
Curtain number two, which you got a couple clues. Something that Ricky was dreaming of seeing someday.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can take this teeny tiny box.
Number two. Curtain two. Yes, curtain
two. Now, what do you think it could be? A trip to Paris. So he laid on his back dreaming of I suppose so. Here's what you passed on.
It was a new Vespa.
Okay, well, you missed out on a Vespa. Ricky said he's laid on his back. He was dreaming of looking up at this and going there. What's behind curtain number two?
It's a trip to Planet Zonk. This deal's worth nothing.
Thank you so much for playing, Margaret. Give her a big round of applause. So nice to meet you, ma'am. All right, now let's make a deal right after this.